Ahokia. I'll call the Honourable Jenny Salesa. Sorry, Minister, I didn't see you there.
Kia ora koutou katoa I te wiki o te reo Māori, kia kaha te reo. This legislation that we are putting through on behalf of the Minister of Education is not just about changing the name. It is absolutely not just about changing educans and inserting teaching. The question posed by the Member of Parliament, Simeon Brown, the council's name should reflect the central role that our teachers have in their own council. It should also ensure that they have the power to elect their own members. This is about democracy, ensuring that our teachers can elect their own members to govern themselves. Several of the questions posed earlier on was, what about the voices of partnership schools? What about the voices of state integrated schools? What about the voices of parents? Well, this legislation provides that the minister will be able to appoint 6 of the members of the 13 members. 7 of the members are elected and 6 are going to be appointed by the minister. The bill provides that in appointing those members, the minister will have regard to their collective skills, their experience, their knowledge in making up the overall composition of the teaching council. It could include all of those other areas that I had questions on earlier on in terms of representation, parents included. In terms of the question posed about the cost, the question was, do we have any advice on how much it will cost to change the name? As far as I'm informed, the Education Council has estimated that changing the name would cost about $220,000. And the question was also posed, is this a good investment of money? We are doing a whole lot in this space. We are, as you know, according to the Honourable Nikki Kay, 13 different working groups, including Tomorrow Schools, NCEA, all of that work comes to Cabinet at the end of this year. And this is but one of the things that the Ministry of Education and the Honourable Minister of Education, the Honourable Chris Hipkins, is working on. One of the things that we know in opposition as well as during the submission process and what teachers have told us many, many times over is they would like to have a say. They would like to elect their own people. When we look at other professions, be they doctors or lawyers or nurses, they have a say in who gets elected and then who governs them. We are giving teachers the respect that they deserve, that they can elect their own to govern their own. Thank you very much, Madam Speaker.
I call the Honourable Nikki Kay.
Chair, look, I am absolutely delighted. Firstly, can I just acknowledge the Honourable Jenny